So using the search tree for practical purposes, we may have already gained some efficiency. But now the question is, does it really affect the running time of the algorithm when we use O-notation and worst case running time? Or is it just something that gives us some constant factor savings in practice? It's hard to tell right now because this tree, as we've considered it, it's highly dependent on the structure of the graph that we're analyzing. And we need to think a little bit more about this. One interesting thing to consider is the following. There were only two cases when we stopped further exploration in this tree here. One case was that we had found a valid vertex cover. The other one was when we considered an edge that could not be covered anymore. Actually, doing it this way is not the smartest possible way, because for vertex cover, we already know one thing. If you look at an edge, such as this one here, then this edge here has two endpoints. And now we want to assign these endpoints to be in the vertex cover or to not be in the vertex cover. So far, we have looked at the vertices individually, but we could also look at both vertices at the same time. So not go into two different possibilities, but actually go in three different possibilities. There's three cases that make sense here of assigning the vertices to be in the vertex cover or not. So we know this edge needs to be covered somehow. And there's actually just three different possibilities of doing that. One is you take this endpoint here into the vertex cover. The other one is you take this vertex here into the vertex cover. Or of course, you can also take both. But you can ignore the case where you would put none of the two endpoints into the vertex cover because then you already know that your solution doesn't make sense. This of course also covers other edges as well. And now our algorithm can actually very quickly come to a solution, because when we look at this edge here, there's only one possible choice that remains, and that is taking this vertex here into the vertex cover. All edges are covered. We have a solution of size 2. So now let's do a worst case analysis and say that this is the edge that the algorithm considers next. In all of the three cases, the edge is uncovered. So it again goes into three possibilities here, three possibilities here, three possibilities here. Of course, if we had been lucky and had chosen this edge here, the algorithm would have had a much easier choice. And actually, we're later going to look at such optimizations for the algorithm. And again, we're going to branch into the three cases that make sense for that edge. So this one here would make sense for that edge, but of course it leads to an invalid solution. This one here is actually the best possible solution. And this one here is also a solution, but it's a larger one. And we're going to do the same thing over here. Now, what you might be thinking is, oh no, now we're trying 9 assignments. But the good thing is that we can now do a worst case analysis of this.